Hi, I'm Siggy from Elgato. And this is Elgato Voice Focus. Now, what you just heard is something releasing within our Wavelength 2.0 software update, and is one of the most exciting features I've seen come out yet for Wavelength, Voice Focus. Partnering with AI Coustics, Voice Focus leverages advanced AI-powered audio technology to ensure that no matter the challenging environments you're recording your audio in, your voice will be the focus. Now, traditionally, when creating content, you usually need to set up your recording space to reduce or remove distractions from your audio. So this can be as simple as closing your window to stop the lawnmower noises from bleeding in, or turning off your air conditioner. Or it can get as involved as setting up acoustic panels or sound blankets to remove reverb or unwanted noises from other rooms in your house. But with Voice Focus, all you need to do to remove these audio distractions is flip a switch. Simply open Wavelength, click the effects icon, and turn on Voice Focus here, and adjust the strength to your desire. And Voice Focus will achieve three key effects. One is background noise removal. So that air conditioner, your dehumidifier, your outside lawnmower will all be removed from your audio. What you just heard in the intro earlier was a dehumidifier about 2 feet away from this Wave 3 microphone. Number two is Voice Focus will remove room echoes or reverb. So if you're in a more empty space and you have a lot of voice reflections happening, Voice Focus will reduce those so you'll sound like you're recording in a sound-treated studio.
Voice Focus is part noise suppressor, part isolator, and heaps of AI sorcery. Voice Focus is part noise suppressor, part isolator, and heaps of AI sorcery.
And number three is Voice Focus will prevent vibration noises from your mic arm or desk stand from creeping into your audio. So if you hit your desk when you're gaming or, you know, you hit your mic arm, you're not going to hear that thud in your audio. So think of it like a virtual shock mount in that aspect. Now, Voice Focus isn't the first audio effect used by content creators for noise removal. So what makes it the best? Well, I think there are three main competitors to Voice Focus. There's RN Noise, Adobe Podcast, and NVIDIA Broadcast. So for this section, I have the dehumidifier on just like it was in the intro, and I'm going to showcase each of these other options in action as I describe how they compare against Voice Focus. Now, RN Noise is a popular option among creators because it's integrated into OBS and is available on both Mac and Windows. However, RN Noise acts more like a smart noise gate versus an actual noise remover. So once you're actually talking, you can hear the background audio with your vocals, and the combination can come across as a bit tinny. Now, Adobe Podcast will remove the background noise entirely and has a good sounding EQ, but the overall sound quality can sound a bit muddy. I think Adobe Podcast is more geared towards removing room echo and EQ versus being a noise remover. And the big caveat with Adobe Podcast is you can't use this in live audio. You have to upload a video or audio file to apply Adobe's plugin to the audio. So this isn't an option for live content. Now for NVIDIA Broadcast, I have both noise removal and room echo removal on. Now, NVIDIA Broadcast is probably the most ubiquitous name in the space for AI noise removal. As I just mentioned, NVIDIA Broadcast can do both noise removal and room echo removal, and in their latest update, they've also added a studio mode, but that does require a higher-end 5 series RTX GPU, so I'm not going to be able to demonstrate that in this video. Now, the issue with NVIDIA is it's available only on Windows and requires an NVIDIA RTX graphics card in order to be used. Now, when it comes down to performance of NVIDIA Broadcast, while it does work well at removing the noise and removing echo, there can be occasional artifacting in the audio in the form of pops and crackles in your voice, which could be a deal breaker to some. Now, the frequency of this artifacting is dependent on a couple things, such as how challenging the space you're recording in is, or if you have a load on your GPU. The harder NVIDIA Broadcast has to work, the more frequent the pops and crackles can be. And now let's move back to Voice Focus. Now, Voice Focus is built right into Wavelength and will work on both Windows and Mac. Voice Focus runs its AI model locally and uses very little resources, so you don't have to worry about system requirements or bogging down your machine. On a modern system, Voice Focus uses between 1 to 2% of CPU power. Now, the major system requirement for Voice Focus is a Wave device. So at the time of this recording, this includes the Wave 1, the Wave 3, the Wave Neo, or Wave XLR and Wave XLR dock. So obviously working with Wave XLR means that whatever XLR mic you have connected to your Wave XLR will work with Voice Focus. Voice Focus works on the Wave mic channel only, so if you have additional USB mics or interfaces connected to Wavelink, they won't have this option under there. Lastly, in terms of performance with Voice Focus compared to the others, I'll leave it to you to make the call yourselves, but I personally think it sounds the best of the bunch. It doesn't have popping or artifacting like NVIDIA Broadcast. The only time I can get Voice Focus to sound noticeably processed is if I were to leave the background noise on and then move the mic really far away from me so Voice Focus is working overtime to treat the audio. So if I were to turn my gain up and then move the microphone here, now you might start to hear it sound a little bit processed, but this is also a super challenging environment because remember, I still have the dehumidifier going right next to me. If I turn this off, this is what it sounds like. But as I turn it back on, it sounds a whole lot better. But the normal use is having the gain a little bit more down and having the microphone close to you where it's going to sound fantastic. So as I said, just using my Wave 3 at a typical distance and having this loud noise very close to me, it works great. I think in my case that the resulting audio might have a slightly less pronounced low end when Voice Focus is on, but that's fixable with EQ to bump the low end back up. Now, one thing I love about Voice Focus's strength slider compared to other apps is other apps' sliders might be considered a fixed strength slider. So if you have it set to 100%, it's working at 100% load even if you're in a quiet environment. So you could be in a sound treated room, but you would still get a lot of artifacting in your audio because the strength is set to 100% and not something like 10 or 20%. Meanwhile, with Voice Focus, I like to leave it on at 100% all the time. Now, if I'm in a quiet space, like if I turn off the dehumidifier here, Voice Focus doesn't have to work that hard to clean things up. But if things get loud around me, like the dehumidifier turns back on, Voice Focus is prepared to make sure that I still sound good. So it's almost like when you set the strength on Voice Focus, you're setting a max strength versus a fixed value strength. Okay, I'm going to turn off the dehumidifier now. Now, as someone who's struggled with audio for years, Voice Focus has been the biggest godsend since ClipGuard for when I'm creating content. To sum things up, Voice Focus is the most compatible AI audio enhancer since it can be used on both Mac and Windows computers with very low system requirements. It can be used for both live and VOD recorded audio, and in my humble opinion, performs better than all the other tools that are currently out there. But don't take my word for it. If you have a Wave microphone or Wave XLR already, this is an absolutely free update. So I invite you to try this out and be the judge yourselves. I think you're really going to love it. Now, if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below. And be sure to hit that like button and get subscribed to both our Elgato YouTube channel and our Elgato Workshop channel to learn how to unlock the full power of your Elgato products. Once again, I'm Steggy from Elgato. And until our next video, good luck and have fun.